rejoice and to be glad in it. And today we are especially thankful for the rain that waters the earth, that reminds us of our baptisms, that gives us life. And so now I invite you to stand as you are able and turn to page 2 of your worship bulletin to the Thanksgiving for Baptism. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, the fountain of living water, the rock who gave us birth, our light and our salvation.
Amen.
Joined to Christ in the waters of baptism, we are clothed with God's mercy and forgiveness. Let us give thanks for the gift of baptism. We give you thanks, O God, for in the beginning your Spirit moved over the waters, and by your word you created the world, calling forth life in which you took delight. Through the waters of the flood you delivered Noah and his family. Through the sea you led your people Israel from slavery into freedom. At the river your son was baptized by John and anointed with the Holy Spirit. By water and your word you claim us as daughters and sons, making us heirs of your promise and servants of all. We praise you for the gift of water that sustains life, and above all, we praise you for the gift of new life in Jesus Christ. Shower us with your Spirit and renew our lives with your forgiveness, grace, and love. To you be given honor and praise through Jesus Christ our Lord, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, now and forever.
Amen.
Amen.
Our gathering song is number 377. Alleluia, Jesus is risen.
Thank you.
worship bulletin. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
Be sure. steward the theater of the church by 7:00.
Thank you. Flowers by Saturday at 10.
Just a reminder, there is a confidential meeting on the 15th to call a certain pastor. And so, just a reminder.
One of those rascals, right? Great. This afternoon at 3 o'clock, if anybody is interested, there is a conference meeting of all of the Lutheran churches in this area. It's the spring conference meeting that always precedes the Synod Assembly in June. So particularly, are there people going to the Synod Assembly this year? Maybe not, okay? If not, stay home. I will be there, and if there's anything exciting that comes out of that meeting, I will certainly relay it to you next week. Other announcements or things to share? Okay, if not, I invite us to continue on with the word part of our service, listening to how God speaks to us in Scripture, in preaching, and song. Showed me the river of the water of life. from the Gospel of John, the 14th chapter.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus answered Judas, not Judas Iscariot, "Those who love me will keep my word, and my Father will love them, and we will come to them and make our home with them. Whoever does not love me does not keep my words, and the word that you hear is not mine, but is from the Father who sent me. I have said these things to you while I am still with you, but the Advocate, the Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send in my name, will teach you everything and remind you of all that I have said to you. Peace I leave with you, my peace I give to you. I do not give to you as the world gives. Do not let your hearts be troubled, and do not let them be afraid. You have heard me say to you, I am going away, and I am coming to you. If you loved me, you would rejoice that I am going to the Father, because the Father is greater than I. And now I have told you this before it occurs, so that when it does occur, you may believe. This is the Gospel of the Lord, Word of God, Word of life.
Thanks be to God.
You may be seated. Will you pray with me this morning? Lord God, may the words of my mouth and the meditations of our hearts be acceptable in your sight, for you are our strength, our rock, and our Redeemer. Amen.
Amen.
Two things about today that I did not say earlier. Today is the sixth Sunday of Easter. There is one more Sunday of the Easter season to go, and then we're on to Pentecost. Pentecost is a particular day when you are invited, if you are able, to wear the color red. Red being reminiscent of the flames that danced on the heads of the gathered apostles and disciples. And red will be the color of the day. So, 2 weeks from now, if you're able to wear red, please do. Today, in addition to being the sixth Sunday of Easter, is the first Sunday of May. In fact, it's May 1st, so happy May Day. But it's also Rachel's Day. Those of you who are wearing your blue ribbons and have maybe read the insert in the bulletin are aware of Rachel's Day and how it began. But to refresh your memory, back in 1994, at Bethel Lutheran Church in Chicago, which I believe is on the south side, in a pretty rough neighborhood, a woman there was concerned about all of the violence, particularly in the city, and how the children and youth were in the midst of that situation, in the midst of drug addicted parents, in the midst of drug trafficking, in the midst of poverty, and all sorts of horrible, horrible things. And her heart went out for children and youth. And she got together with other women in her church, and they got a vacant city lot, and they transformed it into a beautiful garden. A garden where people could come and meditate, a garden where people could find some peace out in the midst of the city. A garden where mothers came to mourn their children who had died. Now, I'm not sure if you know, but there are two leading causes of death for people under the age of 25 in our country. And they tend to be pretty close to each other in terms of which one is top and which one is second. So, one of them is through traffic accidents. We all know that young drivers tend to get excited sometimes and do things that maybe are beyond their ability. Or sometimes young children are in cars where there is a crash and they're thrown through windows because they're not secured correctly. The other cause of death is gun violence. And that's what I'd like to talk about a little bit this morning. I know that guns are not a topic that you normally hear about in church, and I'm not going to be political in any way about it. At least I hope not. Fact, in the year 2013, in this country, 2,465 children and youth under the age of 19 were killed by gun violence. Of those, 1,410 were homicides, 877 were suicides, 124 were accidental or unintentional, 20 were by legal intervention, and 34 were of undetermined intent. This means that an average of 8 young people are killed every day in this country. I don't think that's a good idea. In today's gospel lesson, we hear Jesus saying to his disciples, "Peace, peace I leave with you, my peace I give to you. I do not give as the world gives peace. Do not let your hearts be troubled, neither let them be afraid." Peace and not being afraid. Jesus says this to his disciples the night when he's going to be betrayed. This is part of last week's gospel lesson, where Jesus is talking to his disciples at what we call the Last Supper. Jesus knows that he's going to be betrayed. He knows that he's going to be denied. He knows that he's going to die. And yet he says to his disciples, "Peace be with you. My peace I give you, not as the world gives peace." This peace that Jesus gives us is peace from God, the peace that passes all understanding. It is a gift to us, just like baptism is a gift to us. And this peace is a result of being claimed as a child of God. This peace is a result of knowing whose we are. We are God's. And who we are. We are children of God. And this is a peace that is not like the peace that we hope for in the world, the peace where war is no war, the peace where there is no more conflict. It is a peace that can be within us, despite everything that's going on around us. It is an inner peace that God gives us that comes out of the confidence of God's love for us. It is a peace that says we don't need to be afraid because we belong to God. Now, our world tries to get us to be afraid of everything under the sun, whether it's people we don't know, or foreigners, or things under our beds or in the closet. The world wants us to be afraid. But Jesus says, "Do not be afraid. You have God's peace that I have given to you." There is no avoiding it, but our world is a world that is not at peace. And it is the peace that God gives us that we can bring to the world. I want to tell you a brief story. about a young boy named Ricardo. Ricardo was one of the young boys in the church that I served way back when in Baltimore City. He came to our after-school program. From the time he started school, the elementary school was just a couple blocks down the road. And he loved to draw. He was incredibly talented and could draw cartoon figures so well that I thought he would have a great career as a cartoonist. He was a happy, wonderful young boy, willing to do anything that he was asked to do, willing to cut up and have fun, willing to share his talent with everybody else. And then he went off to middle school. Now, middle school was about a mile away, and he walked. Now, this is inner city Baltimore, and you can imagine that in a mile between his house and the middle school, that there was a lot of temptation, shall we say, because we're church people, but there was a lot of stuff that he could get into. And he did. Before long, he got involved in a minor gang, one that trafficked in drugs, and he became a drug runner. And that went on for a while. He nearly flunked one of his grades. But then that summer, something happened with him, and he came to himself, and he decided, I don't want this life anymore of doing bad stuff. And so to separate himself from that, he stayed indoors at his grandmother's. He lived with his grandmother for 2 weeks solid. He didn't go out at all. And after, he wanted to stay away from the influences. After 2 weeks, he was pretty much stir crazy. And so he decided to go a few blocks and visit his other grandmother. On the way, he was shot and killed. Sometimes, as much as we in the church do to try to bring peace into the world, sometimes it doesn't work. That church that I was serving, not only did it have an after-school program, but it got together with 14 or so other Lutheran churches in the city. And we wrote for grants and all sorts of things. And we had an 8-week summer program from 9 in the morning till 3 in the afternoon for young kids. And we focused on reconciliation, peacemaking, through music, through art, through activities and dramas, through any way that we could imagine to help these youth learn different ways of resolving differences without resorting to violence. Ricardo was part of that. Sometimes, despite the best we can do, it doesn't work. But that shouldn't stop us from trying. Patrice, a young woman, who was also part of our summer program and after-school program, is now married with 2 children and is a pharmacist in Boston, Massachusetts. Good things happen when we share God's love, when we share the peace that passes all understanding. Now, I'm not going to try not to be all pie in the sky, because I know we can't solve all of the problems in the world. But there are things that you and I can do to share this peace of God with those around us. I'm going to be a little bit concrete here. The first has to do with, yes, guns. If you have one at home, please be sure that it is locked up, that the ammunition is separate from it. And that children and or grandchildren or anybody who enters your home is safe from that gun. Because we like to think that our children and grandchildren don't know where these things are. Ha! If it can be found, it will be. You know that as well as I do. Next, if you have relatives, sons, daughters, grandsons, granddaughters, aunts, uncles, whatever, spread that word to make sure that the guns that we have are kept safely away from those who don't know how to use them properly or who might try to show off to friends. Keep them safe. And today, as we celebrate or remember Rachel's Day, and Rachel, by the way, you probably know, comes from that passage in Jeremiah that says, "A voice is heard in Ramah, lamentation and bitter weeping. Rachel is weeping for her children. She refuses to be comforted for her children because they are no more. Thus says the Lord, keep your voice from weeping and your eyes from tears, for there is reward for your work, says the Lord." There is reward for our work. Not all the time will we be successful. But the little things that we can do can make a difference. God gives us peace. A peace that goes beyond what the world can even imagine. So that even in the midst of all that the world throws at us, even in the midst of the hard times, we can be at peace because we know that God loves us. God loves you. God loves each and every one of us. And guess what? There's nothing that we can do that can change that. There is nothing that can separate us from God's love in Christ Jesus. St. Paul tells us that neither height nor depth, nor angels, nor principalities, nor things present, nor things to come, nor anything else in all of creation can separate us from God's love in Jesus Christ our Lord. It was our Lord Jesus who loved us so much that he gave himself for us. You have an insert in your bulletin, the white one, that looks something like this, hopefully just like this. On the back side is a litany for Rachel's Day. And I'm going to invite you to pray this litany with me as we think about the children, the youth of our world, and as we think about making a difference for them. You all get to start. So that we may see the value of all God's children, and that we may together plan for their safety and protection. So that we may hear the cries of the youth who are suffering from hunger and malnutrition, that we may together plan for their food and sustenance. So that we may feel the powerlessness of the teens who are struggling to succeed in homes plagued with apathy, divisions, anger, hopelessness, and that we may help provide words of comfort, paths of power and courage for their successful journey to adulthood.
Open our lips, God.
So that we may boldly confront racism and sexism, and that we may together bring about the unity in diversity necessary for our babies' growth and wholeness.
Open our minds, God.
And purge away individualism, negative pride, and superior attitudes, and help us to understand that each and every child of God is given bountiful gifts regardless of color, gender, or race.
Open our arms, God.
So that we may welcome children whose parents are incarcerated, absent from the home, or struggling with addiction, and help us together provide them with the love, strength, and stability needed to run this race of life.
Open us, God, so that we may feel the breath of your Spirit.
Open us, God, so that together we may be strengthened to bring about human liberation and wholeness for our children. Amen. And now may the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep our hearts and our minds in Christ Jesus. Amen. Life and love of Christ Jesus, we pray for the life of the church, the the lives of people in need, and the life of all creation.
Holy God, ruler of the nations, renew your call to all people. Raise up leaders who are eager to follow you with justice, love, and truth. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Nourish all lands through springs, rivers, lakes, pools, and irrigation systems. Produce abundant food by the flowing of your spirit throughout creation. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Help us to extend your hospitality and inspire us to share the grace of Christ in places near and far. Use even small interactions to usher in peace for all people. Bless our military at home and abroad, including Tyler, Jeremy, Jason, Annalisa, Michael, Andrew, Michael, and Angela. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Send compassion and service to those who live with health concerns of body, mind, and spirit. Deliver your healing and peace to all who need it, including Brad and Wilbur Vaughn, Carol, Tom, Dick, Betty, Don, Cecil, Mary Wayne Mason, Earl Faye Martin, Della Miller, Betty, Carol, Algie, Linda, Lemma Heimer, Agnes, Harold, Gail, Paul and Linda Eisenhower, Kelly, Pete, Chuck, Randall, Dot and Linda Bumble, Lucy, Harrishay, Bob, Trey, Bud, Willow, Shirley, Tracy, Angie, Doris, Richard, Billy, Kathy, Wendy, Carolyn Sigmund, and all those on our prayer list. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Grant the burdens of people who long to work, yet remain unemployed or underemployed. Give them dignity when they seek help. Place them where the gifts may be used. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
You have given blessed salvation to all your saints, including John Smith and Yvonne Turner. Thank you for writing our names also in the book of life. Make us Christ's presence for others while we await his coming. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
We deliver all this into your care, O God, trusting in the work of your Holy Spirit to bring all things into the risen life of Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Now, the gift of peace that God gives us, we give to one another. The peace of Christ be with you always.
And also with you.
Peace be with you, man.
Peace be with you, man.
Peace be with you. It's my bad. You good? Peace be with you. Shaking it out.
Please. Keep an eye on Renee because I just dropped a bomb that Cecil's been, the hospice been calling on Cecil.
No, well, she's having a hard time.
So kind of watch her.
Yeah, I talked to Jill's going to talk to her because she's been crying all morning. I hate that. We could go over there. Huh? Be happy.
Sure.
Will you do the prayer breakfast first or the money first?
Why don't you do the money first? That way people have a place to put their prayer.
Okay.
Jesus, who, living among us, healed the sick, fed the hungry, and with a love stronger than death, gave his life for others. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." Remembering, therefore, his life-giving death and glorious resurrection, we await your promised life for all this dying world. Breathe your spirit on us and on this bread and cup. Carry us in your arms from death to life, that we may live as your chosen ones, clothed in the righteousness of Christ. Through him, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, with the Holy Spirit, in your holy church, both now and forever. Amen. Gathered into one by the Holy Spirit, let us pray as Jesus taught us.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power and glory, forever and ever. Amen.
We come to the Lord's table not because we are deserving, but because we are loved and forgiven. The table of life is spread before you.
Please come in the mercy of God.
the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ strengthen us and keep us in his grace.
Amen. Amen.
No, you don't go Rock Corner. You go all the way down Shook Road is.
You know it, don't you?
Like you're heading past Bunker Hill High School, Shook Road, turn on to Shook Road. It's called Shook Town Road. Turn on Shook Town Road, and it's out that way, but it's on the right. Catawba Valley at Rock Barn or something like that. Catawba Valley Living at Rock Barn. But you just turn on the Shook Town Road, and once you pass the golf course, you pass the stables, you pass all that. Rock Barn. I was telling him how to get out to Catawba Valley Assisted Living.
Maybe.
It's on Shook Town Road, I know.
I've been involved with him for a while. I think, you know, that.
Because he was on oxygen, but like I said, we got word through some of the managers at Hardee's, because that's where he came for breakfast every day. David was the one that came out and told me.
Shook Down Road, where it is, right, just when you get go to the bridge, past the barn,
right.
Shook Town turns to the left, and if you go out 16.
Do you pass the high school before you get there? Bunker Hill?
Oh, no.
Yeah, I'm sure we can.
It's on. The road, Rock Barn Road is the road where you turn in at the
entrance.
Yeah, it's just right down the hill, at the bottom of the hill. It's the bridge.
Well, they probably will have some more professionals turn in some stuff.
Mm-hmm. At the bottom, their profession turns off to the right.
And can't make it really well, so. We'll get
of course, if you keep going, you may have a great big old curve down the bottom of the hill.
You've seen the Rock Barn Bridge. Well, just past the entrance, it's like you could almost throw a stone down there.
And it's on the right.
Is it? Is hospice coming over?
You see,
you
no
pass,
problem.
Pass, you're already on Shook Road.
Right. Okay.
Yeah, but past the bridge, you turn to the left, and yes, it's on the right.
Yeah, it's on the right.
I would say you can't miss it, but I've missed it.
It's possible.
Yeah.
We'll see y'all Tuesday.
They CD and CD player and all that stuff. And he's great, so funny. He laughed. And about his younger days in funeral homes and stuff like that. It was just fun. See, man, he worked at a funeral home when he was young. He was a baby story. He dropped one of the bodies out of the funeral home. Well, it fell over. He went around the curb and fell over, and the body fell out inside the hearse. And we laughed so much, and he just knew that the owner, which I think is this one up here, drums or whatever, back in the older days. He said, I went around the curb, and it just turned over, and he fell out. I took him what to do. He was a big man. And, you know, he was 16, 17, 18 years old.
Oh, shit, not at least two.
Can you imagine us laughing? I mean, you can laugh now about it, but he was, you know, I couldn't get my breath. I was laughing so hard. I could just see it. And he got about five of them out there to help him load the man back in there. You know? That's but we had some good time. Oh, my God, you had some good stories. I'm telling you. Yeah, we just good stuff. That's funny, you know. You know, you see her crying for what she's praying. She can't sing. You know, she lost a couple of people this week. She ran and across the street, which is her aunt's daughter. She got to the funeral yesterday. So that was trying to have an increase on mother's life. But, of course, any time we see her, she's not going to. Anyway, it is what it is. The older you get, it happens. Well, have a blessed day. Cut that air off.
I just did, dog.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
I think we're doing like that up there. But Renee told me that was a sign when she fans herself, when a preacher fans herself, so cooled off a little bit.
Yeah, it was hot.
I'm sorry.
Well, it was just a...
And she got that move on, you have to understand. That's why I can't move, right? You'll pick me up off the ground, because I will find
you. You have to get about three of us to do that.
Now, don't! Oh, it's really going to be a bad shape this afternoon. Ellen's coming back today, then?
Yeah, sure.
Kathy, is that door locked?
Yes.
Okay.
All right, Dawn. You got what else?
Yeah, did you bring Mike back?
Huh? Oh, no, I didn't. I'm sorry. I forgot. Did you? Here, Doris, you want these back because you can use these again, can't you?
Well, we can.
Well, yeah. I ain't gonna see them. Wait a minute.
Be
a good idea.
Renee, nobody coming in here messing with these this stuff here, are they?
No,
the kids or anything?
No, the kids are not coming in there. They're staying back there with me.
I mean, I'm trying to line up, but it blares when you do that, so I can't do anything.
I don't know. Just keep the door, lock the door then.
I gotta have another way of locking it.
So, they made our conference.
Oh, yeah. Did they?
Everybody on the team.
Whoa.
And they're all going to regionals.
Oh,
where is that at?
I don't know, but it's the same day as the AP test.
Well, they've done locked this one.
How could that be?
We don't know.
Well, that's poor planning on somebody's behalf.
So we're trying to figure out how in the heck they're going to do it, because half the test team's on that taking the AP test.
That's poor planning on somebody's part.
And that's where he is. That's where he is today. Their study group met this morning. I wasn't real happy about it, but I mean, what do you say?
We'll give you one of them.
What is that?
That's such a relaxing sleep thing.
It's, do you know what a Reiki master is?
Uh-huh.
Okay. I got it from a Reiki master. In fact, I went to ballet